a woman of great faith. I'm a wife, a mother, a sister, a friend. I'm a certified life coach. I am most importantly a mentor. And I am the CEO and founder of Mean Girls Empowerment. Mean Girls is a 501c3 not-for-profit organization. It stands for Manage Emotions, Avoid Negativity. Our organization aims to prevent bullying, and pretty much we teach girls how to identify bullying behaviors. We seek to empower girls to avoid negativity, build self-confidence, and to seek out their divine passion and purpose.
Growing up as a young child, I was bullied. I was a different type of girl. I would consider myself to be unique in my own way. And through those challenges of being bullied, being talked about, being mistreated by my peers, you know, I dealt with certain things at a young age, such as self-esteem, low self-esteem, depression, loneliness, which caused me to withdraw myself from others. And so, you know, with great influential people around me, mentors that were able to say, no, that's not who you are. They brought out the best in me, and they were able to basically remind me of who God says I am. And so after graduating from college, I actually had the opportunity to partner with a few high schools and mentor a few girls. And I noticed that these girls have the same issues and experienced the same things that I experienced growing up as a young child. It was so much girl drama, fighting, being misunderstood, girls that were bullied, girls who were the bullies. And so basically I saw that as an opportunity to start an organization where girls, it can be a girl-friendly network, and girls were comfortable to come together, although they were different. I couldn't quit. I was the only positive role model that they had in their lives. Did it get challenging? Yes. I started with a handful of girls, and as I continued to press through, in addition, the message that I was giving these girls, it was also coming back to me as well, because we're living in a real world where there's negativity all around us. And so I was empowering myself as well as empowering these younger girls. So no, I didn't quit, but as I continued to move forth with Mean Girls, my organization began to expand. I feel like that comes from a young girl who is crying inside, who is crying for attention, who's crying to be heard, who's not confident in herself. A young lady who probably has a dysfunctional family or have something that's going on that she needs help. It's something that she sees that she wants in someone else. Yeah, we do have some girls that are just typically me, and they're probably misunderstood, you know, but I think that, you know, those girls with a little coaching, like Mean Girls, come to our workshops, you know, they'll learn how to soften up around the edges. But most girls who are really like involved in like bullying, I definitely think that there is something behind that. There's a shell that needs to be open. And my organization, I personally try to find out what is the root cause of this. I think we need to understand. And oftentimes I talk to these young ladies and it's like, so why are you like this? And why did you choose to do this? And why did you choose to do that? And so how do you think that made her feel? And then oftentimes they actually open up and pour out all these tears, like, well, Miss Tina, this happened to me. And, you know, I felt this way because she had better shoes than me. And it's like, really? Really? And so, and I think too, as young ladies, you know, we deal with so many things like puberty. You know, that's something that, you know, we're growing up, our bodies are changing. And so a lot of times we can't control that. we can't control that sometimes. And I think that that's also a cause where it's like, I'm different, she looked different, her hair is long, my hair is short, she's light skinned, she's prettier, I'm dark skinned, I don't feel comfortable with my skin complexion. So it's kind of like, it's just the nature of the beast. We're looking around and we're comparing ourselves to others. And I think that that's sometimes that stems to, you know, bullying, when you don't, it's a lack of something which causes these girls to bully. Pretty much, I want Mean Girls Empowerment to be a movement. I don't want it to just be a small not-for-profit organization in South Highland. I want us to be a movement. I want to see this organization expand across the nations. I want to be a voice to young girls in Africa who are being bullied, in China, in Europe, wherever. I want Mean Girls to ring across the nations. And so if that was one of my dreams, I want God to really expand my territory and expand this organization's territory.
We have to empower our young ladies. We have some, it's so important. As equivalent to how the Girl Scouts is. You know, when they need tools to strengthen and empower our young ladies, educate them, give them certain skills, they use Girl Scouts. I want Mean Girls just as strong as that.
It's amazing to have a support system like Thomas. Like, seriously, he wants the best for me. As you guys can see, he wants to make sure that this organization is successful. Thomas understands the passion of Mean Girls. You know, when I wasn't talking to anybody, like, I gotta start this group, he was like, whatever you need to do, let's get it done. And so I really appreciate Thomas. I appreciate him so much. God has blessed me with a tremendous husband, you know, that sees my vision. And it's important that your spouse sees the vision that God has given you.
A woman that is uncovered, transparent, a woman that is bold, a woman that is confident in my skin, who I am as a person. Nothing's covering me, nothing is hiding my personality. It's just me being me. And so that's what it means to me to be a totally connected woman. I pretty much inspire these young ladies to be who you are. Don't, you know, identify yourself with a label. You know, be who you are. You are who you say you are. Be comfortable and confident in the decisions that you make. Be transparent. Be truthful. Be honest. Be inspiring. Be you. And so that's what I continue to push these young ladies to just be them. Don't worry about what people say. People are going to talk. Don't worry about the negative influences around you. Continue to push towards your dream. So we're having a brunch on May 26th. This brunch is gonna be super dope. What I did was actually, I had the community nominate girls who are doing outstanding things within Chicago. And we're gonna actually be honoring these young ladies. They are simply amazing. And they're under the age of, I believe they're all under the age of 16. We're gonna have so much fun. We're gonna have food, music. You don't wanna miss it. It's a event where we're gonna pour into our young ladies and we're gonna empower you guys. You don't have to wait until you graduate from college. You don't have to, you know, wait to be an entrepreneur. You could be one right now. To purchase tickets, please visit our website at www.meangirlsempowerment.com.